you think you can tell? Heaven from hell, blue skies from pain. Can you tell a green field from a cold steel rail? A smile from a veil. Do you think you can tell? And did I get you to trade your heroes for ghosts? Hot ashes for trees. Hot air for a cold breeze. Cold comfort for change. And did you exchange a walk on a part in the war for a lead role in a cage?
Amazingly, this year, even with the world crisis, the economic crisis that's affecting everybody and most of Indonesia is as well, everybody knows that these are hard times. There's a lot of panic going on. Even through all of that, this year we've accomplished so much, it's just beyond belief. At the start of the year, at the fundraiser last year, we were quite concerned that, you know, we wouldn't be able to do what we had hoped for, and believe it or not, we've actually achieved more than I'd ever dreamed of.
One of the unique aspects of the Sumba Foundation experience is donors have an opportunity to come visit and participate in projects if they like. Clean water is a huge problem in Sumba.
La, 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 la. La na 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 na.
You're not just getting drinking water out of a well that we produce and people donate to. It's also much more than that, and it'll link into farming, which links into better diet and better health. We've got 13 primary schools that we're supporting.
Years ago, we had one little clinic at Hopewawi with one government midwife, and there were very, very few tools. No microscopy, no specific equipment or anything, just some basic drugs and one government midwife. So now, looking back 6 years later, we have five clinics spread over 30 square kilometers large area. We have 14 nurses, five clinic assistants, and one Indonesian medical doctor. So a very, very strong team now of very well-educated people, and we have trained them very thoroughly over the last couple of years.
The malnutrition issue is quite serious. Amazingly, there's kids starving here that the mothers don't even know what it is. They think it's something else. They don't realize that their children are just not eating right. So far this year, we've put about 200 children through this program, and this is direct intervention. It started about a year and a half ago, and last year, this past year, it really came into its own. Rainey is in charge of that. She really works hard. She loves what she's doing, and she's really helping a lot of people.
It's been my 2 years working here, and it means a lot for me because I know with my basic education, I can help another Sumbanese that really need my help, and it's really great to see kids can stay alive because we help them.
There's tens of thousands more, and we hope to be able to, you know, solve all of this one way or the other. And it's not just, you know, it's never going to be solved by direct intervention. This is why we're talking about water projects and farming projects and school lunch projects. All of these are all linked together.
Very, very proud and happy about the team we have right now. They're excellent. Without them, there's no way we could achieve as much as we are doing.
It's a blessing to working with the Sumba Foundation.
all of the health thing, it's been a little bit frustrating that it's clear that we're not going to be able to achieve our goal of really helping all of Sumba as fast as we want to.
I've always hoped that one day we'd be able to help the whole of the island with malaria control. And the reason for that is, I feel, most clearly illustrated by the case of Celestiana.
Waiting on an angel, one to carry me home. Hope you come.
Celestiana's parents come from Kodi. It's 80 kilometers from Nihiwatu. They come to see me with their really sick daughter, Celestiana. They asking me for some food because they hear about our malnutrition program and food program.
She came from a hospital that unfortunately didn't treat her with the correct medicine, so she continued to have the malaria, and actually they didn't help her very much.
She's paralyzed, she cannot speak, and she's just crying.
Angel, hear my plea.
We want to make a quick impact, not just on Sumba, but on the whole region here. We need to improve the skills of the microscopist. Klaus has been working very hard on this. It's been a huge effort.
The Goldman Sachs Bank has given us a grant to start a malaria microscopy training center. So this means a center that can certify malaria microscopists from all over Sumba with a full certification. This is a huge first step in the direction of providing good diagnosis for all the clinics on Sumba Island, all the government clinics, all the private clinics, and all the hospitals.
It's going to be something that's amazing, and something that's very important, and something that's going to save thousands of lives.
Angel, hear my plea. Take my hand, lift me up so that I
bring her directly to our clinic.
And in last effort of desperation, when she was most atrophied, we immediately diagnosed her and cured her and helped her with nutrition.
And I'm waiting on an angel, and I know it won't be long.
We put her in malnutrition program, giving her milk, eggs, vitamin also every day.
We continue to operate extremely lean, with 90% of all donations going directly to programs. Try and direct the most dollars to having the largest impact.
Okay, this man has a white cataract in his right eye.
Again in 2009, we invited the eye team from Australia, Dr. Mark Ellis and his group, to come and perform eye surgery in Sumba. We did it again at a public hospital in the center of Waikabubak, the capital of West Sumba, and it was very successful.
It just might be an angel.
But believe me, you know, if you ever come here and see it, you'll understand why it's important that people just get together and one place at a time, a lot of people collectively around the world will be able to create massive change that sometimes are not possible by governments, no matter how good their intentions are.